Hello and welcome to another Nico Media tutorial. So today we do again a little modeling, and on my Facebook group I got a question about this one here. A follower sent me this picture and he asked if I can show how to do this, how to model this one, such a key. Yeah, and it wouldn't be Nico Media if I would ignore this question. So I want to show you how you can make this with subdivision surface, and it's not so hard as it looks. It maybe looks so. Let's begin. Let's see. We have here, a normal disk should do it here. So I go in the top view here, normal disk. With NH, I can see the wireframe here. And yeah, I need here for the moment just two. This is the inside, this hole, what comes here, and the outside. Okay, so let's make this editable. See on the keyboard. Okay, go in point mode with UL for loop selection, and I loop select this guy here and make it smaller a little bit. So let's say it's a 60 by 60. Okay, then I select this middle point 2, so with shift select I've selected the middle point 2 and drag everything up here a little bit, so somewhere like here this should be fine. And now I select just the middle point here and delete it, so we have this hole. Yeah, nice, we have a hole. Next step, I go in polygon mode and select my polygons here and make an inner extrude with I on the keyboard. I inner extrude and just extrude it a little to the inside, something like this should be fine. Then let's make this this part here. So I go in edge mode and let's say 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. Oops, not this one. Then this should be enough. Yes, then I hold my Then I hold my control key and drag this down here just a little bit. So I want that I have the same size with this edge, about with this edge, about the same size. Okay. And now again, control, drag it down. So here. Then I drag a little bit down, control, drag. So that's this here. Then I delete these two edges here, and again control drag a little bit, and then more, so something like this. Okay, and this here is smaller, this space is here is sharper, will this edge will be here become. So if I make this further away, so we get a rounder edge, and if you make this very close, these edges, so you get a sharper edge. But this should work like this. Okay, it looks like a key. But now we need this nice shape here, this thing here. So I need here, let's say 1 and 2 cuts around. So one for this, one for this. So let's make KL for a loop cut. In older versions you press just K for the knife tool and go in loop mode. So and I say make one cut here, about here, we can change everything later on, so and one about here. Okay, these two cuts should be fine. Then I hit UM for a path selection and I select this guys here, these edges. T for scale and make them straight, so scale this down. I hold my shift key and scale it down until 0. See, 0%, okay. And E to move it a little up here, so it looks something like this. The same I make here, but from here to here. I can click here on this edge and control shift and click. Click here so you see I get this thing here. T for scale again and scale it down with the shift key, hold the shift key and scale it down to 0. E and make it something like this here. Okay, this is more than less everything we need for the moment. So now I want to bring out to extrude this outer edge here, this one inside here, and parts of this one. I'll show you in the original one. Now we want to extrude these parts here. So okay, so I select everything what I want to extrude. So I go to my polygon mode. And let's see, I want to extrude this, and this here. Then UL for loop selection and hold the shift key to add the selection here. So this one, and I want to extrude this one here. And then we can change this selections later on. What I want to now, I want to say, do this here, and this not, this here. As I said, we can change this later on. I make just so. Let's say I want to extrude everything this here. Looks like this here. Okay, I save my selection. So set selection. I have it here in my toolbar. If you don't have it in your toolbar, go to select and here set selection. So now this selection is stored. The next thing is, I work with the Pi extrude modifier with the Pi tools from Maxon. This so you can extrude without converting or without. So you can change everything later on. So, and you will find this this here under Labs MaxonNet. The link is in my description of the video too, and here you will find the Pi parametrics tools, and if you click on this you get all them. They are free and they work in R22 as you can see, and here you can download it. So good with them. Now back here. So I shift click on this Pi extrude modifier, shift click, so that it becomes a child of the disk. You see, it does something, it extruded it, but I wanna extrude it just on this selection. So I drag in this selection here and restrict the polygon selection. Now you see, okay, this is what I want. This is exactly what I want. And if I drag this now, or if I put this now in the subdivision surface, so I select my disk and with Alt click on the subdivision surface, so the Alt becomes parent to the disk. Check, you see, okay, that looks something like we need, but it looks everything a little, so this is too high, let's go to about 2. It looks too smooth everything, you see. And to change this, let's make the disk. To change this, just go to the modifier here and bring in some subdivisions. Let's say one subdivision, sharper. Two subdivisions, very sharp. So how sharp you want it, I think one is enough, but we can change this later. We will work parametrics, so we can change this later on. And it looks not bad. But I want more subdivisions in the subdivision surface because this looks a little edgy here. So go here to 3. Okay, nice. And with NI, I see the isoparms, and you see we have here almost the same mesh like we have here. And if you say okay, this does not look like I want it, so let's go to I want this further down here, so this is no problem. You go to our disk, edge mode, our edge is still selected, you see. If not, deactivate the subdivision, select whatever you want here, then go to the subdivision and drag just a little down here. So okay, this looks a little nicer for me. Or I go back and say no, I want this knot and this knot, and now I drag it down. Yeah, that looks better. So nice. Maybe I go down with this a little too. Yeah, that looks a little high here, so I go take this or make this even rounder. But I think I go to here. Control shift click. Oh, this does not work here. Sometimes it works not, so UM for the path selection. Whoops. So E for the move tool. Drag this down a little bit until I like it. Okay. Here I want this a little to the inside. These two points here. So I go to the point mode here. T for scale, scale them a little down together here. E a little down here. So you can play until you find your desired shape. Yeah, this looks nice. So okay. Then I find this looks too round for me. So we need here a control cut. And I'll show you what this does. We go in the subdivision surface. Now KL for the loop cut. And you see we can cut a loop here. And I'll make here a control cut somewhere here. You see, okay, this looks much nicer. Okay, so far so good. Let's see, we have a very nice mesh here, but you see we have here something I don't like. That looks a little better when we give this little thickness here, but at the moment I want to do everything now before I extrude the whole thing, because now it's easier to work with it. So I want this little sharper here, so I don't want it, so we can do this when we go to the edge mode here. And what I do now is I want here this edge a little rounder. So with UM for the path selection, select this here. Is this the right one? Well, let's see. Yeah, until here this is okay. This was okay. And now with MO I go to the slide tool, hold my control key, so I copy this edge here. I don't move it, I copy it with the control key. So go to the you can do this here as well. So you can set here your values and go here to clone. This clone is the same like the control key. So I drag this a little to the inside here. Okay. I try to get here something like we can drag the whole thing inside the back. So UM, go down here. So MO for the slide tool. Sometimes it makes it a little weird. Sometimes the slide tool. Back. Ah, I forgot to hold the control key. So yeah, okay. It's nice, and now let's see if this is better here. Let's resolution surface. Not really better. But it doesn't matter. We make this again now. With UM, the path selection, I select this again. And MO and control, drag it a little to the outside now. So this is sometimes it doesn't really work. So, okay. Good. And now we should have a sharper edge when we do this whole thing. Boing. See, now we have a sharper edge here. This is exactly what I wanted. We have a very, very nice edge flow here, exactly how it should be. This we do in a second. We make the same here on the other side, that we have this a little sharper. So, and go to the disk, edge, UM for the, for the move tool. And drag it this down, so D this to the outside, MO. We should have here that this is the same value as we had the last time, so let's try if this works. I click inside and just hit enter. Okay, this goes in the wrong direction, so Control C and just delete the minus in front of this. Okay. Again, UM for the bus selection, and now I select everything here. Again, MO. Now we should go in the other direction, minus, enter. Okay. And this should be it. Now we have the same on the other side. Very nice, sharp edge here, everything looks great. Now we make here a control cut to have here a sharp edge, so go to the disk, edge mode, KL for a loop cut, and we loop cut here, and it looks great. So far, so good. Okay, our key is almost ready. You see, we have here a really nice key, a nice mesh, everything nice, but now we want it for the little thickness here, and then we make some details. I show you how you can change your things here. Yeah, this looks too symmetric for me. Okay, let's make this first. So go out here, go to the double click the selection deck. So instead of this one, I want this one here. So I'll show you what I mean. This is easier. I go to the polygon mode, I select, so everything what is selected will be extruded later, you know. Okay, but I don't want this to be extruded. Okay. So, and this looks a little weird, so we change here a little the mesh. With MO, again, in the slide tool, I'm in the point mode now, so I can slide this to here. The slide tool has this advantage to the move tool. It slides along the edges, so you don't have to be careful. Bring this a little to the inside here, so maybe this too. So something like this. And now let's see what we get. And don't forget, now I have selected a different selection. So we have, be aware that this we selected this selection deck here and override it. So just again, set selection. Now we have the selection updated, and now when we go to here, you see the selection works here. And let's make it, now it looks like this. Okay, it looks not so symmetric, exactly what I like. Maybe I want a little thing here, because on the original one you see we have a little thing here. Let's make this too. Let's go in micro mode. UM, in edge mode, UM. The path selection, I select here the path, MO for the slide tool, control click to copy this edge, so something like this. Okay, I make here another loop cut because I want to not extrude this thing, but then it would be smaller, you will see, but I make KL a loop cut and a control cut here, so something like this. Okay, another again UM. Okay, this is okay. MO for the slide tool again, control click and make another thing here. So this is just to get again sharper edges. And now I double click here and with the live selection tool 9. I deselect this one here, so I don't want to be this one to be extruded. So you see it better here. So everything what is white now, so it's what is not selected will not be extruded. This is exactly what I want. But let's go. And maybe we need another control cut later. Or we do it. We go it like until here. Now let's see. I think now it's better with another control cut, I think. So don't forget to update the selection deck. The selection deck has to be selected. Set selection. Let's see what we get. See? But now this is exactly what I thought. So you see, it's very tight here. And this is not what I want. But this is very simple. We go into edge mode. KL for the loop cut. And make here about here another cut, and you see now it looks nice here, and everything looks nice because we have this, we have a nice edge here too, and it looks better when it's then extruded because we made this inner extrude, this slide edge, and now this is ready. Take off. Maybe let's make some tooth here. So teeth, not tooth. Teeth. Okay. So for the teeth, I make now not a loop cut. I want a plane cut with KJ. I have plane cut tool. You can make it with free, you can go somewhere, click and drag it to here and hold your shift key so you are straight. This, you can do it like this, or you go to here to local and take the correct axis here. You see, this works as well. So I make here one, I make just one teeth here, so okay. And go point mode. See, I do everything before I extrude at the last thing because so it's much easier to work on one layer here and one. And so okay, and so that this comes not, that becomes not too round. For this, I make some support cuts here. So I make this KJ again. One cut here. As smaller they are together, as sharper the edge will be. One, two, one, two. So, let's see what we get now. 1 second, I have to answer the here. So, sorry for the, okay, you have not recognized, I think, this break. So now we have this tooth here, this teeth. Okay. And you see we have a sharp edge here. This is exactly what I want. So, and you, of course you can make more like this, but for the tutorial one is enough, I think. And now we make the, give this whole thing a little thickness. For this, it's very easy. If you want it on just one side, this extrusion, you can make it parametric. You can take another extruding modifier here, take it above the old one. But you see, this is nothing. And now, in this one, we need create caps. Okay, I see it's done. Activate this one. And you see, okay, this kind of works, but in the wrong direction. So I make both of these into minus. Here, this is too much. Let's say we give it 3. And but minus 3. And here, the old one, I say minus 2. Now, bring this in a subdivision surface. Make the thickness here a little sharper, so 1, 2, and we have something like this. We have everything we want, parametric, but we have it just on one side, you see. if you want these extrusions on both sides, you have to do it a little different. So I delete the new one. So we have exactly the same. Here we go back to plus. So okay, this is like we were before. And now extrude modifier. I bring this out for the moment. Here I take now the extrude generator, not the modifier, and hold the Alt click and make it parent the disk. And you see we get some thickness. That's nice. And I want caps here. So this is okay. Let's make it 3. And here again, 1, 2 subdivisions. You see we have the subdivision surface on. We have a nice shape here. And now I make this editable, this Pi extrude generator. I do it with the edit optimize script I have here. The link is in the description. And but you can press C and then optimize everything. But with the edit optimize script, it makes everything okay. This one is the front, what makes the Pi extruder. This, I don't need this. This is our selection. I bring back this guy here and drag in again the selection. Now I have this on both sides. See? Now it's a little too much here, so I go maybe to 1 centimeter. However you want it, of course. So R. And we have this nice key. And we are ready. See, everything, everywhere we have wonderful mesh, wonderful edges, everything works great. We have just quads, we have no triangles, nothing. Everything is exactly like it should be. And that's it. Nothing more to do here. We have a wonderful thing. And let's see, I want maybe a little higher here, so I could let's go to 2. It looks maybe a little better. Okay. And you can still make some changes, but now it's a little more difficult because you may have to do everything on both sides. So when you hit the selection, you see, now you have to do everything on both sides. But if you do it from the top view and with the live selection, just go to only select visible elements, disable this, so you select both sides then. So yeah, that's it. More is not to say here. You can now still easily make a new teeth here, so just make the same cuts with the plane cut. You go through the whole object, so it's no problem. Let's make another one so that I can show you what I mean. KJ for the plane cut. Let's see, let's make another one here. 1, 2, 3. Okay, point mode. Then I go with 0. I go to my rectangle selection. The rectangle selection selects everything, even the not visible parts. So drag it to here. Not so far, so. And KJ for some support cuts. We know it meanwhile, so for sharp edges, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, and we are done. We have another teeth here. See how easy this works, and everything looks great. Okay. This was it for now. And you see, half an hour, we have a wonderful key. And I hope you like this one. And another tutorial will come on weekend, of course. And yeah, this was more a quick tip than a tutorial, I think. But I like this kind of modeling, subdivision surface. This is sub-D modeling. I really like it. And you see, if you once got it, it's not really hard to do something like this. You don't forget for sharper edges, just support cuts and something else. Don't forget that you can move, also slide edges, so you don't have to cut everything. And when you slide the edges for sharper edges here, don't forget to hold your control key or set the slide tool to clone. And more is not to say here. That's it, we have a nice key here. Okay, that's it, and yeah, I hope you like this. If you have some questions, requests, complaints, please write in the comments or on my Facebook group, Facebook site, website, email, blah blah blah. You know it, write me a letter if you want. And yeah. Next tutorial will come soon. So, please subscribe to my Facebook group. So you see, if there comes an answer, it will be answered as fast as possible. Even faster, it will be answered on Patreon. So if you want to support me on Patreon, you will find the link in the description, or you just, if you want to just donate a little bit, so you can find the link in the description as well. Okay, I say thanks for watching and best regards from Vienna, and yeah, that's it for now. Tschüss und Baba.